Hey there, my name is Tolor, and this is the third video in my series How to Make It Happen in LOTV. In this video I want to show you how to make air armies, because over the course of a game you gradually want to switch your ground units for air units, because those are way better in the late game. The ultimate goal is to have an army that consists nearly only of battlecruisers and ravens, because this army is, in my opinion, the strongest army in the game, if you micro it well. And how you want to micro it, I want to show you video. So the first thing you want to do is to assign rapid fire hotkeys. You don't know how to do that, I'll link a video in the description. And generally it means that you don't have to click the mouse button to find a target for a skill, for example auto turrets, because if you click with the mouse button it looks like this, and this isn't really fast. As you can see, the last turret is about 3 to 4 seconds after the first turret. And if you use rapid fire hotkeys, you can do it like this, which is way faster. Rapid fire hotkeys definitely make the most sense for auto turrets. But it also makes sense for Yamato cannon, because if you use Yamato with the rapid fire, it's like this. Not even a second to use all the 5 Yamatos. It also can make sense for liberators, because the liberation zones will get on way faster than when you do it manually, like this. But you don't always want to use rapid fire for the defender mode, because with rapid fire you don't have as high an accuracy for the target of the skills. So rapid fire is used mostly for skills that you can spam.
Easy.
And not for skills that you want to have a target for. With that, it can make sense to use rapid fire for Hunter Seeker missiles. I personally don't use it, but you could use it. And it doesn't really make sense for point defense drones, because point defense drones are a very situative spell, and you want to have high control over how many and where you use the point defense drones. So the second thing I want to talk about is you have to get used to use more than one control group. At the very least you need 2 control groups, one for the Ravens and one for the Vikings. Because if you have your Ravens and your Vikings in the same control group and you make an attack move and want to micro now, you have to click on the Ravens themselves to micro them, and they will be in front of your Vikings, which means they are vulnerable. And also, you don't really have a possibility to micro your Vikings back, because your Ravens will just throw back at the army of the opponent. And so, yeah, you'll lose your Ravens and the worst part, even the Vikings. So what you want to do is you put your Vikings and the Ravens in separate control groups, and always have the ravens behind the Vikings. With that, you can use all your spells. Like this, for example. And micro back your Vikings simultaneously. And so, we lost only a couple of Vikings, and all the Ravens, which are the important units, survived. Okay, about Viking Raven. In the mid game, or late mid game, you want to have the units you had before, like tanks, Hellions, Thors, maybe. Plus a couple of Ravens and a couple of Vikings, with most of the time you want to have more Vikings than Ravens. And when you are in fight, you want to attack move your Vikings and use the spells of the Ravens. With the priority, you first throw down a couple of point defense draws. If you fight against something that is affected by point defense drawn, as a general rule, you want to have a point defense drawn every 2 or 3 Ravens. So with 5 Ravens, that would be 2 point defense drawns. And then you want to use Hunter Seeker Missile. And with all the energy that's left, you build auto turrets. So let's do this fight. Opponent has many Vikings. We just attack move our Vikings, put down point defense drones. Have all our Hunter Seeker missiles and throw down a couple of auto turrets. And we lost all our Vikings, but that's okay because Vikings aren't really expensive. But all the Ravens have survived. And this is the important part, because Ravens are really, really expensive. Okay, about Battlecruiser Raven. This is an extreme late game scenario, where you have many Battlecruisers and many Ravens, and a lot of missile turrets, and not much else. And the opponent, for example, the Protoss, who builds mass carriers. The Protoss can't attack into you, because this many missile turrets will just destroy those carriers together with the Battlecruisers and Ravens. And so, you want to kill his army, but you don't really want to engage it openly, because in an open fight you will definitely use many units. And so, with Battlecruiser Raven, the idea is to fight his army with Yamato and Hunter Seeker missile without losing many units. So, what you do is, you use your Battlecruisers and use all your Yamatos. And with Shift Command, you just move back your Battlecruisers. And the same thing you do with your Ravens. You just go into his proximity and use Hunter Seeker missiles and go away. And with each of these rounds, with Yamato and Hunter Seeker missile, you will kill a couple of units, and he can't engage because, well, those missile turrets. And you shouldn't use all your energy on the Ravens while attacking, because if you use all of your energy, he can just attack you, because you don't have much to defend. If the opponent has spellcasters, for example, High Templars or Infestors or Vipers, you don't want to attack with all your Ravens at once to not risk to lose your whole army, but you just get a couple of your Ravens. at best those with most energy.
Command authority registered.
To go to this army and stay at the top of your range and just use a couple of Hunter Seeker missiles. If the opponent tries to attack, you just throw down a couple of auto turrets. And don't risk any of your ravens. So, and you have to be really patient, because it will take a long time to kill a big army like this. But you don't risk any of your units, because every time you attack, you just do a couple of Yamatos and teleport back. And if the opponent has something that can be blocked by point defense drone, you should also always take a couple of ravens with you when you attack with the battle cruisers and throw down some point defense drones before you attack. And also a couple of missile turrets are also always very good. Especially against carriers, it's really important that you use defense upgrades. Because a carrier gets plus 1 damage, per attack upgrade, which means plus 20%. And the other way around, you lower his damage by 20% for each defense upgrade you do, and this is really a lot. So yeah, you want when you are in late game, you just want to stay back, stay safe, and kill a couple of his units every time you cooldown on Yamato is ready, or you have enough energy for Hunter Seeker missile. Now, what should you focus with your abilities? Here we have a typical Protoss late game army consisting of many Voidways, a couple of carriers, a couple of Tempests, many Stalkers, and a couple of High Templars. With the Yamato, the thing you want to focus is the High Templars, because the High Templars can really be very strong against the Ravens, so you want to get rid of those. And if you don't get to the High Templars, the next thing you want to focus is with Yamato, the carriers. Because you need 2 Yamatos per carrier. And those carriers are really expensive. Tempests aren't really a thing you want to focus with Yamato, because in an actual fight, Tempests don't really do much damage. And you can easily clear them up at the end of the fight. And also, Tempests aren't really expensive. So, carriers are better to focus with Yamato. Also, the Tempests will generally be in back of the army, and you have to move all your battle cruisers over his army to attack the Tempests. Void Rays are okay to focus, because you only need 1 Yamato to kill a Void Ray. If he has that many Void Rays, they kill Battlecruisers pretty fast, so you don't want to have your Battlecruisers near to his Void Rays. Yeah, and with Ravens, you want to throw down a couple of point defense drones first, because they block the Stalkers and the Tempests. And they do a bonus, or they are a target more for feedback from the High Templars, so that the Ravens are protected more. And With a Hunter Seeker missile, you want to target the void rays. Of course, those tend to clump up and are killed by two or three Hunter Seeker missiles. Carriers are also okay to target because they also tend to clump up, but they aren't killed as easily. Stalkers, they are okay, but not really what you want to focus with Hunter Seeker missiles. But if you have excess energy, that's definitely a thing to do. And as always, if you have spare energy, just go down a couple of auto turrets, because they deal really much damage. So yeah, that was it for Protoss. Now a Terran. Well, for Terran it's difficult because there are many things he can do. If he also has many battlecruisers and many ravens, you want to focus the ravens with the Mato cannon. Because they can't move away, and a Yamato cannon kills one Raven, and it's really expensive. And for battlecruisers, you need two Yamatos. So, and also, I think he can just teleport out of it. Battlecruiser can just teleport out of Yamato, and so this isn't really a good target. So with Yamato you want to focus Ravens if he goes Battlecruiser Raven. And for the Battlecruisers you want to throw down auto turrets. And well, not really Hunter Seeker missiles, because also those can be evaded by just teleporting. So yeah, auto turrets are the best thing to do against battlecruisers. There are also Terrans who just go Viking and Raven against battlecruiser Raven. Then you just, if he attacks, you just teleport back. Low battlecruisers with a couple of point defense drones and Hunter Seeker missiles, and generally this will be enough to deal with the Vikings, and with the Ravens you just come out with them. There are also Terrans that just go mass bio and a couple of tanks in late game with medivacs. And with that you want to focus the tanks with the Yamato cannon, because those can kill your missile turrets from a range. And against the ground army you want to have a couple of tanks, and if he just like this stims under your units, you fight with the battlecruisers and throw down auto turrets, mass auto turrets. So, and against Zerg, he could have, like, let's say, 5 infestors and 5 Vipers, and also like very many Corruptors. And with that, it's the same principle as against Protoss. You want to target the spellcasters first with the Yamato cannon. And if you're in a fight, you just throw down a couple of defense drones against the Corruptors, throw Hunter Seeker missiles and just move away. And as such, you just kill all those Corruptors. Now let's see how this looks in a in an actual game. This is a ladder game I played. So it went pretty okay until this point. We are pretty even in army supply and army value, I think too. Yeah, I'm a bit better in army value, but most of my army is tanks that are tied this position, so we are about even. And I have, I think, five Vikings, 9 Ravens. And I see that he attacks at this position where I have a couple of tanks, but not really much. And my Vikings and Ravens have to get to this fight. So let's see how this goes. He kills a tank first, and now I want to focus his Vipers with my Vikings and throw down a couple of Fantastica missiles to let him get away and possibly kill some of his Vipers. I don't get a kill, but it's still okay because now his Vipers are way behind and I still have a couple of Fantastica missiles and enough energy for auto turrets. And here comes Vipers again, but they have to get back because there are that many auto turrets. And the Vikings are in the back, just shooting stuff and not really doing much. And because he is in this choke point, he loses his whole army, but his Vipers survive, so it was okay for him. Not really good, but it isn't something that would loosen the game, because you see he has enough of a bank to just rebuild his army. So yeah, what I did was try to zone out his Vipers with the Vikings and throw down a couple of Fantastica missiles and auto turrets to fight his army. Yeah, and sometimes at such an attack there will already be corruptors with it, but if you can, you should definitely try to focus the Vipers with your Vikings, because the Vipers are really the important. Also, when you are in that low of numbers, it would actually be better to use auto turrets instead of Fantasica missiles, because Fantasica missiles only get strong in high numbers because of the big AoE radius, and auto turrets are generally better against low numbers of units. Okay, let's see how this progresses. We both stay back for a while, and I try to harass with my Hellions, nothing special. And now I start Battlecruiser production and have a good amount of Ravens. And because he doesn't have many Corruptors, I also didn't build many Vikings more. There are 11 Vikings, and this is the point where I don't build any Vikings anymore. Now, if you have that many Ravens, they bank up energy really fast. So you can just use them to harass your opponent and possibly get out a couple of bases, a couple of drones or something else. To harass with your Ravens, you should always use those with high energy, and you mustn't risk your Ravens. So you should be sure that the opponent's army is out of position, Or you have to have a really fast retreat point, like here. You can, if my ravens are here and his army comes from like here or here, I can just retreat my ravens into the safety of the missile turrets and the tanks and don't risk the ravens at all. Generally, the ravens shouldn't go far away from your base. So now at this point, I try to trade away my Vikings, because it is the Vikings aren't really something I want to have in the late game, and I think I might be able to get a good trade on them. And now we see 2 point defense drones down, and the opponent throws down parasitic bombs. And the first thing you have to do when you get a parasitic bomb on your units, you have to split away those units that are affected by parasitic bomb. And in the retreat, you can always use a couple of Fantasica missiles. Well, it got 2 kills, that's not bad. But especially it forces the opponent to get back and your air unit are safe again. So there should be a big fight soon.
Who called in the upgrade complete?
And in that fight, I think I have a couple of battlecruisers already, and lots of ravens and a couple of Vikings still that I couldn't trade away that good at that moment. And yeah, I think now begins a big fight. But first, if we look at my control groups, we see at number 2 I have my battlecruisers, at number 3 I have all my ravens, and at number 4 I have all my Vikings. This is what I talked about earlier, because you really have to have your ravens in a separate control group, and if you have your Vikings in a separate control group, you can easily kite with them. And the battlecruisers are in a control group to have fast access to Yamato. And at this point, you don't need to have your tanks in the control group, because those stand here anyways. And the Thors would be nice to have in the control group, but isn't really necessary. So now he wastes a couple of torches before the actual fight. And there comes his Broodlords, and I immediately unseach my tanks. This is really important, because else they just kill all your stuff. And now we see a Yamato the Broodlords, because they are really expensive. I tried to Yamato the Vipers, but they were out of range. And the Ravens I had at the back, because I didn't want to risk having 3 parasitic bomb on those Ravens, which could possibly kill them really fast. And I lost a couple of Vikings, but as I said, I already wanted to trade them away. So now we get into the stage of BC Raven I talked about earlier, where you sit back at your base and use Yamato and Fantasica missile to get a couple of kills.
Who called in the fleet?
And don't do really much else. So we should see soon that I fly my battlecruisers to him to possibly get a couple of kills and possibly a couple of ravens as an escort for them. I'm not sure if I did that in this game. Oh yeah, I think I did. So here I see his army is back there, so I don't really need to have my ravens with them, because the BCs can just teleport away. And yeah, you see, I just Yamato them and teleport back. I could have teleported back a little further, but there were already my ravens, so it didn't matter. And yeah, it is pretty important that you get out his vipers and also his infestors, because at one they are really expensive and they are really strong against air units. So here I have a couple of ravens that were on high energy but now aren't anymore, that just throw down a couple of Hunter Seeker missiles in the hope of getting some kills. That didn't really work at that point, but you don't, well, energy regenerates, so it's okay. I get a kill with a Hunter Seeker missile on a Viper and two Corruptors in trade of one Raven, so this was actually really good. And now I really, really don't want to have my Vikings anymore, so I just kind of throw them away. I get, I think, one or two Corruptors for them and get to bait out his infestors, so this was really okay. It was a bit sloppy to lose these both battlecruisers here, but as long as you trade more efficient as the opponent, you still can lose a couple of units, especially if you're on the same base amount. And yeah, at this point the game is pretty much over. The opponent has two mining bases and I have one and a half, but my army is just so much more expensive and so much stronger that he doesn't have a chance to kill my army anymore. Now, lastly, a couple of tips. PDDs are good against units that attack slow but strong, like Corruptors or Tempests, Stalkers or Vikings. And if the opponent has those units in his army, you generally want to have 1 point defense drone per two or three Ravens. And another tip, BCs can teleport out of Parasitic Bomb and they can teleport while being fungled. So if they are affected by those spells, you just teleport them back and everything is okay. Then I told you to use Yamato and Tata Sika missile in the late game to get a couple of kills. And while you do that, your units will probably be attacked. So in the downtime where you can't attack, you really should repair your units. That is generally always a good idea, but at this point it's really important. Then the last tip I have is that Yamato doesn't one-hit spores, so spore crawlers, but it one-hits turrets, spines and cannons, and also has more range than those. So when you fight against Terran or Protoss, it's always a good idea to Yamato his static defense. Against Zerg, if you don't have any other targets, it's also okay to Yamato spore crawlers, but it isn't really the best thing to do. And that was it. Thank you for watching, and until next time.